on the base swing. It's a long one, a long one.
The lucky of the hand on the face of the edge.
Baseball is a game of moments.
Fastball hit deep to right. It's looking it. Way back there. Oh, God.
Moments that are never forgotten.
Tunnel, there you go.
October 14th, 1976. Your moment has come.
With some speed.
So nobody moved, huh?
What did happen?
We didn't think it was going to be easy, though. So we'll be back.
Starting still winning. Expose a few weaknesses late in the game.
Doug, that's the way you hit the baseball.
One of the largest 9/11 groups, and we've had a lot of the Yankee family organization work before with Bucky and some others, and Ron Guidry and a lot of other great guys, Joe Torre. So it was my dear on my 40th birthday to come down here and do the Yankee Fantasy Camp. So check it off, but I'll be back every year for 41, 42, 43. So I think it was just great. When you come out on the field the first time, being a lifelong Yankee fan, it just gives me chills in my body, and then seeing the greats like Roy White, Chris Chambliss, Bucky, Mickey. I'm in awe. I've been in awe every day I've been here, and I pinched myself, David Wells. We were out last night, having lunch with Bucky today. So this is the most awesome experience I could have ever had.
What's the best part about hanging out with those guys, with the coaches, the former
players? The stories. I mean, just listening to Bucky tell me about the trade that he had with Lee Mazzilli and how he felt, and David Wells telling all of his stories from his perfect game to when he came back and pitched in the 0-3 World Series. Amazing. I mean, just feel like one of the guys. We're all first-timers, and we just bonded from day one. So it's a perfect team. And Roy White and Chris Chambliss are two of the classiest. I'm sure you're going to hear this on everybody's video, but they're the two classiest guys. And I'm in awe to be perfect team to be on.
I've been out. We started off with all these guys are first-time campers, so we really didn't know what to expect. And the name of our team is the Thunder, so I didn't know if we were really going to have any Thunder. But as it turned out, we really do. We have some... the ball players that can really hit the ball pretty well. We have some power. And even guys that looked like they couldn't hit in the beginning are getting base hits now. So it's been very gratifying watching how well these guys have progressed since day one.
Hey, you waited on that really good.
Where's the oxygen? Where's the oxygen?
Pleasure, fellas.
Good job.
All right, fellas.
All right.
Nice game.
Thunder. And when I call your names, just come out along the third base line. Take your bows. So for the Thunder, Mike Dempsey, Raleigh, North Carolina. Matthew Kowalczyk from Chatham, New Jersey. So now Mike Dempsey, Raleigh, North Carolina. Next one home. Round of foul. They're at home plate. Now the pitch. Broken back. Comebacker. Grabbed by Wells to second base for the out. So Mike Dempsey with his wife Amy and daughters Celli and Jenna in attendance. This is their fourth play. And now, so that's our game. A great with the 2-0 victory over the Thunder. And shortly, we will have the Greats versus the Bambinos.
I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a...
Tell me why. Tell me why. Tell me why.
Hey! Hey! Come back to you.
the second inning. Great with a 3-0 lead on the Thunder.
And here is number 49, Mike Dempsey. Number 8, Jim Hoffman. 49, Mike Dempsey. From Brooklyn, New York. Mike fouls it away. Favorite Yankees, Ron Guidry. Amy. Youngest daughter Jenna is here. Here's the one strike delivery. Fresh count here. Liner knocked down at third base. The recovery and the throw across is in time for out number 3.
Two to one.
Yeah, baby! messed it up.
Dempsey. Number one, Andrew Gordon. Ground ball, deep at shortstop. Throw to second base with a force, and that's it. So the game is over, and the Yankee Greats capture another one. 4-0 on the line.
Thank you.
the screen. 3-2.
You got this, Mike. On your face shot, baby. Face shot.
There's a long one. Left field way and caught. Out number three, but the... Ron Guidry. Six camps now for Mike Dempsey. Wearing that favorite 49. Sinking, base hit. Runner around second base holding.
All right, come on now. Do it too now.
Hold now, Champ Powers comes up. Out of level left bounce. Fly ball. Right center field. Got a carry on it. And it's going to land and roll. So the game is tied. Runner going to third base, and he is not stopping, coming home. Here's the throw, gotta be close, in with a dive, safe! The Bombers get the go-ahead run on a textbook slide. Throw to second for one, on to first, two. Double play, but a run on the board for the Pinstripes. 1-0. Pinstripes leading the Bombers after two.
Mike on first base, two outs, and Our hitter hits a long drive, deep left center. So I'm looking at the ball, and all of a sudden I look down, I'm looking for him to be like round the second, going to third.
He was still first.
He was still like 10 feet from first base, looking at it.
He'll be charged.
Didn't know the outs. That cost us a run also.
Oh, caused a run?
That's right. Guy only got a single.
I need a lawyer.
You
need a lawyer? Help me or what?
You want, you need a lawyer?
Yeah.
What happened?
I need a lawyer.
Might be a mistake.
All right. I don't recommend it.
Nah, we can't go that hard on it.
All right.
Oh, yeah. You want a lawyer?
I can't help you then.
It's supposed to be.
Go
ahead.
You want the lawyer?
Public defender.
You want the public defender or you want to pay the court?
If the case with him, it's going to be worse.
What do you guys think?
No, they think it already. They paying up.
I'm at the mercy.
Yeah. All right, $20.
All right.
You,
all
right. The team, $5.
Oh.
Night and he's going to come back and he's going to be a coach on your team. I said to Sturtze, I said, what the hell's wrong with me and you? We need Stick. He goes, well, everybody else has got 3. We said, so what? It's been me and you right under the bus, man.
I'm guilty.
Huh?
He's wrecking us out.
What do we got?
I'm doing what?
Cages. I went 60 miles an hour in the cage. I'm lobbing that shit. You fuckers can't even hit it. In 60, I can tell you that. Tried to get us fired yesterday with Stick Michael.
Rick?
Last night, who'd you take to dinner?
Players and...
Me and Bucky had room service last night. 2 cheesesteaks and beans. The other 2 coaches had fucking steaks. $50.
In my defense, if you guys still made it the field yesterday, I felt bad.
Not my coaches. What did you tell me that for? He told me. $10. And I thought it was his coach. No, $50.
Threw him under the bus. There's no rats in this fucking clubhouse. Jeez.
I had a right under the bus.
Attorney, come on.
Thank you.
Viking, yeah. Viking. You got it.
Yesterday, and he comes up, and he remember when he took that big old hack and he got jammed.
Oh,
back. So he's walking back, so I pass by, and that old saying, I said, get the key out. And he looked at me, and he goes, what? I said, get the key out. And he said, the key. I said, when you go by the clipboard on the wall over there by the bat, like there's a key there, get it out. Here's my...
Soak it up like we do in the clubhouse and the hair the ribbing that goes on if Mickey stops talking all the time. But I want to say thank you. We had a blast. I'm sure we got some awards, but no one on my
team again down the road. And we had a bunch of new guys this year, and we hope we groomed them right to bring them back. Thank you very much.
Camaraderie that we shared. I enjoyed it. Thanks for having me back here this year.